First of all, this is not just a simple list of shortcuts. I selected the most fundamental actions you can make in Illustrator and broke them down into every single way you can make them and every shortcut you can use. Before we start, something that might help you. Always pay attention to the status bar, which is located at the very bottom of Illustrator, especially this part here. By default, it'll always tell you which tool you currently have selected. We'll see more about it in a bit. Okay, let's get into it now. Starting with the foundation of Illustrator, we have the selection tools. These are the very first shortcuts you gotta learn, because these tools are the ones you spend the most time with. These tools allow you to select, move, rotate, and scale not only entire objects, but also anchor points, groups, and clipping masks. These tools are the selection tool and the direct selection tool. The selection tool uses the shortcut V, and the direct selection uses the shortcut A. An easy way to remember them is thinking about the shapes of the letters. Both A and V kinda look like a mouse cursor, which is the icon of the tools. A very cool feature about the selection tools is that you can temporarily alternate between the two of them by holding Ctrl, or Command if you're on a Mac. So if you're using the selection tool, you can turn it into the direct selection by pressing Ctrl, and when you release it, it'll get back to the selection tool. The same happens the other way around as well. Bonus tips. For both tools, you can either select by clicking or box select by clicking and dragging. Holding the Shift key toggles the selection, and that means you can hold Shift to select multiple objects or anchor points, but also to remove them from the selection. If you hold Shift while moving, scaling, or rotating, it'll always lock the movement in a certain way. Also, most tools will turn into one of the selection tools when you hold the Ctrl or Command key. For example, if you're using the Type tool, hold Ctrl and you get the selection tool. If you're using one of the Shape tools, hold Ctrl and you get the selection tool. The Pen tool, hold Ctrl and you get the direct selection, and so on. Oh, and remember that I told you to pay attention to the status bar? Look what happens when I use the selection tool. Now, when I press Ctrl or Command, and now when I hold Shift. Cool, right? That's the easiest way to know how a specific key, like Ctrl, Alt, or Shift, may change the functionality of the tool you're using. Now, on to the next one. Cutting, copying, pasting, and duplicating. These seem like simple tasks, but Illustrator has some kinda hidden features you might not be aware of. For example, everybody knows that you can copy with Ctrl or Command C and paste with Ctrl or Command V. But Illustrator actually has four more ways to paste an object. Ctrl or Command F to paste in front, Ctrl or Command B to paste in back, Ctrl or Command Shift V to paste in place, and finally, Ctrl or Command Shift Alt V to paste on all artboards. These commands will always paste the copied objects in a position relative to the artboard. So if you copy an object from one artboard to the other, it'll always paste in the exact same location. That is, if both artboards are the same size. And I say this because the actual reference point used to paste the objects using these commands is the top left corner of the artboard. I know it sounds confusing, but it really is simple. If you paste the object in a different artboard with a different size, Illustrator will calculate the position using the top left corner as a reference, even if it means the object will be placed outside of the artboard. A cool feature about the paste in front and paste in back commands is that they can use both the artboard itself or an object as a reference point for the stacking order. So, if you have a series of objects in your artboard, but none of them is selected, paste in back will paste the object behind everything, and paste in front will paste the object in front of everything. However, if you select a specific object, paste in front will paste in the front of the selected object, but below everything else that is on top. The same happens with paste in back. It'll paste behind the selected object, but above everything else that is in the back. Now, the paste in place command, you can just ignore. In my opinion, it is kinda useless. And that's because it simply pastes the object in the same place, but always on top of everything. So it's basically the same thing as using paste in front. The paste in all artboards, however, is absolutely useful, especially if you're making some kind of presentation that requires the same general layout on all of the pages. Simply copy the objects and use the shortcut Ctrl or Command Shift Alt V, and they will be pasted on all artboards. Just be careful, because this command will also paste the objects on top of the artboard you copied them from. So maybe it's better to use cut instead of copy. The shortcut for cutting is Ctrl or Command X. For those of you who find the Ctrl-Shift-Alt-V shortcut a little too much, all these paste options can also be accessed through the Edit menu. And last, but definitely not least, while using the selection tool, you can also duplicate an object by holding the Alt key, then clicking and dragging the object. Whew, that is a lot of pasting options, Adobe. Next, we have panning and zooming in the artboard, and there's quite a lot of shortcuts to these as well. The most obvious ones are the hand tool, shortcut H, and the zoom tool, shortcut Z. Though, rather than selecting these tools, there are quicker ways to perform these actions. For panning, my preferred method is holding the spacebar, then clicking and dragging. It's simple and fast, mainly because the spacebar is a key that is kinda always at the reach of your thumb on the keyboard. But even better than using the spacebar is clicking and dragging using the mouse wheel. I just don't use this shortcut as frequently because it is a rather new feature, so I got really used to panning with the spacebar. However, both of them are perfectly fine and they are the ones you should focus on getting used to. The best thing about these two shortcuts is that they don't require you to change the tool you're using. After you release the mouse click, you'll always go back to the tool you were using before. In fact, if you pay attention to the toolbar, you notice that the tool you're using doesn't even get deselected, both while holding the spacebar and while clicking with the mouse wheel. Alternatively, you can also pan around the artboard vertically by scrolling the mouse wheel, and horizontally by holding Ctrl or Command and scrolling the mouse wheel. If you also hold Shift while scrolling, it'll move a greater distance with each step of the scroll. But I kinda never use this intentionally. And yes, you can also use the scroll bars, but why would you do it? Please, don't do it. For zooming, you can select the zoom tool and click to zoom in, or hold Alt and click to zoom out. If you click and drag sideways, you'll smoothly zoom in and out. However, similarly to the hand tool, you can also zoom without deselecting the tool you're currently using, and you do that by holding the Alt key and scrolling with the mouse wheel. Scroll up to zoom in, and scroll down to zoom out. You can also zoom in and out by pressing Ctrl or Command and the plus or minus symbols. Ctrl plus zooms in, and Ctrl minus zooms out. If you need a very specific zoom level, you can also input it in the status bar, or choose a predefined one from this drop-down menu. Is it a drop-down menu if it drops up? Lastly, you can also use the shortcuts Ctrl or Command 1 and Ctrl or Command 0. And the cool thing about these shortcuts is that they combine both panning and zooming at the same time. Both of them will center the view on the selected artboard, but Ctrl 1 will set the zoom to 100%, meaning that 1 pixel in the artboard will be equal to 1 pixel in your screen, and Ctrl 0 will set the zoom to fit on screen, basically making your artboard take as much space as possible in your workspace. Okay, that was a lot of information for a single video, and we just covered a handful of actions. But remember, the timestamps for each section are in the description below, and you can always come back and watch it again if you forget about something. And that concludes today's video. I hope you learned something new. Thank you for watching, and have a great day. Bye!